please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Asian markets, they're off to a mixed start. Remember, the markets have shaken off some of the trade jitters that were seen overnight.
Half a percent higher, 11,000. So that's the pleasant sight. Some fireworks is in order.
6,000, 444 mark has been reached.
So that's a record high.
All-time high for the Sensex as well.
The fact that we're above 11,000 mark, it's been a thin rally. Only 20 of the Nifty stocks have been in the green since those levels.
It's actually turning out to be a fantastic session for us. We have the Nifty, which is above 11,000. We have the Sensex, which has surpassed all-time record high.
Reliance has become the second Indian company after TCS to touch the $100 billion market capitalization.
Big boys, Reliance Industries and HDFC Twins, they're batting for the bulls.
Market is... holding on very strong, 118, 119 points. But what's not holding on is the small cap index. It's now come off quite a bit from the high.
Okay, you could be looking at Sensex and Nifty and saying that it's been all-time high, the market celebrating, but broader market is once again painting a different picture. So once again, a bit of a dichotomy in the market. Let's see what the last hour brings for us. This is weekly options expiry as well. It's closing bell. I'm Anuj. With me is Surabhi. Hi, Surabhi. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Anuj. I guess, and that's why this all-time high is a little different, right?
Yeah.
Because you've still got the mid-cap index still sulking. I think about 14-15% still away from its peak. So, it's like saying it's Diwali, but it's not quite Diwali.
No, it's not. And, you know, it's actually masking a lot of things. I just did a Twitter poll, Surabhi, when Sensex hit all-time high, what is your portfolio done? The Sensex is at all-time high. 9% is at all-time high. You know, the people with, large caps in your portfolio, like TCS, Bajaj Finance, have been, really good. 23% are within 10% of highs. Look at the rest, 47% and over 20% off highs. I'm assuming some of them are over 30% or 40% off highs. Excuse me. So, and not just mid-cap index, even the Sensex Nifty. This, for me, is the market action today, intraday, is a bit reminiscent of what had happened once, when we had, I think, a rate cut and the market had hit new highs. And after that, a big slide. I'm not saying that, the market is going to slide in last hour of trade. All I'm trying to say here is that this does not feel like new high. The Nifty is at 11,000, but just look at the contribution once again. Yesterday we were discussing, it was TCS and a couple of other stocks. Today you'd have Reliance with 46 points and HDFC Twins, another 25 points. That's all. I mean, the three stocks are accounting for all of Nifty's gains. So it's a very narrow market. Even on the Nifty, the market is very narrow. I hate to use this term index management, but I mean, if this is not index management, then I don't know what would be. And broader market, and this kind of dichotomy does not exist, should not exist. If it is there, then obviously there's something wrong with the market.
Okay, well, we'll see what the next 1 hour has in store. For now, the index is holding that 11,000 level. Well, let's tell you what's lined up as we go forward on closing bell today. The Nifty has reclaimed the 11,000 mark for what it's worth. The Sensex hitting fresh record highs. We discuss the fundamentals of the market with Mr. S.P. Tulsian of sptulsian.com, market expert Prakash Divan, as well as Dilip Bhatt of Prabhudas Leeladhar. Ahead of the weekly Nifty bank expiry, we will be joined by P.R. Sundar. He's an options trader and he gave us a couple of strategies in the morning. We'll see if they're working out now as we are getting closer to the end of the session. And of course, the market surging to record highs. Is it a good time to invest in mid-caps? That's the clear question. Should you be going back to mid-caps? We ask our alpha manager, Rajesh Kothari of Alpha Accurate Advisors. And last but not the least, all the technicals coming up for you as well. And one of the questions we'll definitely put to Ashwini as well as Mitesh today is Reliance Industries in this mega 5% up move. What to do with the stock next?
Okay. How should you position yourself in this last hour of trade then? Ashwini and Mitesh are with us. Good afternoon. Ashwini, slipped off a bit. Mid-caps are under pressure, but on the large cap, there's minor slip that you've seen from the high point for the Nifty and the Bank Nifty. Your thoughts for last hour of trade?
See, first of all, for the record, last 3.5 months, I've made 100%. So it's possible to make money if you learn how. If you keep getting involved in that multi-bagger crap, then you are in trouble. I think this bit of an intraday sell-off will probably rally a bit in the last hour, not go to fresh intraday highs. But I think, you know, we'll consolidate before taking out all-time high if we have to. So for a few days, maybe 10,950, 11,050, you know, that sort of range can hold on, because immediately Reliance is done, TCS is done. Now, which is the next large cap which can come in? So market is getting narrow. I mean, with like 10 stocks, 15 stocks making new highs, things will get a little difficult. But for the last hour, because most of the banks are holding on, I think it should be useful to buy into the Bank Nifty as well as several banks. This sort of a move does not tend to peter out, you know, without any reason. Europe is doing well, crude is still lower. So that those reasons remain. I think in the morning, you know, there was too much exuberance and, you know, that steam was let off. Having said that, I think Bajaj Finance is a buy with a stop of 2400, target of 2510. Arvind is a buy with a stop of 412, target of 430. And IndusInd Bank is a buy with a stop of 1930, target of 1980.
Okay. So going with a couple of buy calls there. That's Ashwini's strategy for the last hour. Mitesh, good afternoon. What's your reading of today's move on the index? And of course, the stocks that you'd go with now.
Good afternoon, Sylvie. So we've been maintaining a positive bias with targets of around 11,017, 11,130. I think we did the first target today and we've slightly come off. But that's okay. We've had about 5 days of up move starting from 10,750. And I did mention that around 11,070, which is the highest ever weekly closing the Nifty has ever had, you will see some profit booking coming. So I think, you know, maybe a few days of sideways activity or consolidation could happen. But the supports now shift to about 10,980 zones. As long as we are above that, I think I'll be comfortable holding on to long positions, though we have taken some profits on the long side on stock specific basis and the index basis. Currently also, I have one buy and one sell. MRF appears to be breaking out of a good contracting pattern, and that's a buy with a stop just below today's low. So 76,400 should be a stop loss. I would look at targets close to about 80,000 over here. And Biocon is a conditional sell. I'm waiting for the stock to break the intraday pivot of 612, 611 half. If it breaks, go short with a stop at 625 and look for targets of 590.
Okay. The market is looking quite okay actually right now, 89 points higher on the Nifty. So there was intraday dip, but not much. And Reliance really has been the stock which has kept the bulls really firmly in the driver's seat. Though there are a couple of mid-caps where we've seen some declines. Strike Chasun is a stock which stands out. Just pull out the intraday chart of that stock, down about 3.5%. And Manappuram is the other one where we've seen some bit of weakness. So both Strides and Manappuram right now at low point. SP Tulsian of SPTulsian.com is with us. Mr. Tulsian, good afternoon. You know, we had you with us, of course, when Reliance hit that market cap of $100 billion. But 1,092 now on that stock. It was just 7 or 8 days back that, you know, when we had seen that correction to 970, 980. And I had asked you and you said that was a golden opportunity. But now, what's the call on the stock at 1,092?
See, Anuj, I think 3 or 4 days back, it was at 965 to 975. In fact, closing also, I think, seemed to have come at 965. Maybe in this week itself. I don't remember. Maybe on the last Friday. And in fact, maybe on that day, either on our channel or maybe on the sister channel, I've said that we are expecting market cap of Reliance Industries to hit 10 lakh crore in the next 30 months. On that day, if I just, you know, remember, on that day, the market cap was closer to about 620,000 crore or maybe 625,000 crore. Today, we have seen market cap having risen to 690,000 crore. That means from 975 to 1,090, you have already seen the stock having risen by about 115 rupees in just maybe 3 or 4 trading sessions, which signifies that how swift the rally can be in any stocks, you know, whether you compare it with TCS having risen, or you see it in the Bajaj Finance, or you see it in the Reliance Industries. And post this Q4 numbers, and my affirmation on the positive affirmation got reiterated on the post the AGM also, where I've said that the two complementing things which are really seen as a margin kicker for the stock is complementing refinery with petchem and Reliance Jio with retail. And I think both the verticals, or in fact if you want to call them four verticals, are seen to be having excellent growth driver or maybe margin kicker seen going ahead, because whatever amount being spent in the refinery, we are seeing the increase in the petchem margin, which in fact is surpassing to a great extent refineries seen continuing with their margins of about maybe closer to $11 a barrel. And if I just come on the Reliance Retail and Reliance Jio, we have already seen 22 crore subscribers having, you know, added into the with the company. And Reliance Retail has already shown the excellent performance for FY18, which in fact was not talked much or maybe have not talked much analyzed, because of in spite of the $10 billion having achieved in FY18 against the all 7-8 listed stocks, posting the combined top line of about maybe 50,000 crore. Mm. So I think going ahead, the things are seen quite positive. In fact, we are taking a call of about 72 rupees EPS on for Reliance Industries for FY19. And in fact, the better part of the earning growth will be seen in FY20 and FY21. Because maybe FY19 still will not see much contribution coming in from Reliance Retail and Reliance Jio. So if you have these kind of time horizon of next 30 months, I don't think that still you can, I have no doubt why we cannot see a growth of about 45% in the virtual or maybe the appreciation in absolute terms in 30 months at the current level also on the stock price.
Okay, sure. In a moment, we'll just have Dilip Bhatt join in the conversation as well. But Ashwini, I wanted your sense on Reliance also, not just from an investment point of view. Mr. Tulsin has already sort of outlined that very, very clearly. Now, for a trader who's watched this rally today, you've already seen the 5%. What do? Do you still piggyback on this and it becomes a positional call because of the momentum? Or should you wait for a dip? I mean, if so, what are the better levels to then get in?
I like the word watch the rally. I mean, you had to get in. The problem now is that in this week, it's up 100 bucks. It can come off 25, 30 rupees. So now, you know, you can't get into things which are up almost 10% in a week. Any sort of declines to previous highs, maybe 1,040, 1,050 should allow you to buy. But overall, it's expanding on the upside. It's expanding on the monthly, weekly, daily. This is the kind of stock that you buy on all corrections. And that's what's interesting, that HDFC Bank, TCS, Reliance, all these large caps are expanding on the upside. So how do they expand? Maybe there is some FII buying which is returning. So that way, you know, it looks like the index will be able to hold on, because one of these guys is likely to participate each time you fall.
Okay, let's also welcome in Dilip into the conversation. Dilip, good afternoon. I'm going to go to the other end of the oil and gas spectrum, the marketing companies. Today, of course, they're all having a field day because of the overnight drop in oil prices. But what's your advice on BPCL, HPCL, IOC now?
Well, I think the knee-jerk reaction that we have seen today is more of celebration that the prices have just come off. But I think the last word still is not out in the market, and I don't know when that will be. But still, my own sense is that oil, the trajectory is definitely upwards, is what I understand from the ratio of opinions which are emerging. So some small correction on the downside doesn't really make us very enthusiastic. I think we will still be a little more cautious on OMCs, oil marketing companies. And more so because we are now getting into an election year, and all the more reason why, in spite of all the freedom that we talk about that these companies have, I'm sure that somewhere their ability to really raise the prices to the desired levels will certainly be curtailed. They may not have the complete flexibility, and as a result, I think the overall profitability can remain a little more subdued. So I would be much more cautious on the OMCs for the time being.
Okay, let's do one thing. We'll take a break on that note. Up next, we'll discuss a lot more stocks. For now, the Nifty is holding 100 points gain. Even the mid-cap index is actually now cutting its losses. So let's see if we can move back towards the high point. For now, the Bank Nifty up 270 points. Of course, weekly options expiry as well. We'll once again be joined by PR Sundar to discuss the morning trades. Most of those trades have worked. Whether you should square them all off right now. Is there still some trades which exist till 3 p.m.? That's all that we'll find out after the break.
Welcome back. So on the index, we're still holding on to levels of 11,000 plus, 11,043 thereabouts. So there's some kind of an up move that's still intact. Sandeep Bagley is joining in with some trading ideas. Sandeep, I wonder what you're going with today. Are you trading large caps or mid caps?
Afternoon, Surbhi. I am being extremely stock specific and I see some selling also. I will sell a Ajanta Pharma that is on the verge of giving a breakdown. Stop loss of 1034, target of 972. And Balrampur Chini looks set for a bigger move. I would buy it with a stop loss of 66 for a target of 73.
Okay, Sandeep, thanks a lot for those trading ideas. Ajanta Pharma is in fact is a stock that we should now get on our radar. That stock down about 2.5% right now. Just see the intraday chart of Ajanta Pharma. It's actually recovered a bit from the low point. Now, news in the morning was that DGCI has raided SafeTab Life Facility, which is manufacturer of medicines for Ajanta Pharma. Now, Ikta, how important is this SafeTab? How much does it contribute to Ajanta? And did it deserve to fall the way it did intraday?
Well, Anuj, you know, as per my sources, they have mentioned that, you know, the SafeTab Pharma, which is basically the company which has been raided by the Indian regulators, the DCGI, only contributes to around 2% in terms of sales for Ajanta Pharma. So Ajanta Pharma does outsource some amount of production, I understand, to SafeTab, but it's only limited to 2%. And, you know, when I did try and quiz the company didn't seem too aware of this piece of news, simply because maybe it isn't that impacted by this particular manufacturer. And secondly, just an additional clarification that it is not in any way or form owned by Ajanta Pharma as well. So overall, yes, it is a sentiment negative, but if you look at it from a financial standpoint, not much contribution at all.
Okay, not much contribution. Ekta, thanks a lot for that. Mr. Ulsen, your thoughts on this, because the stock is recovering as we speak. In fact, if you see the intraday chart on Ajanta Pharma, but again, it's a stock which has not done too well over the last 6 months.
That's right, Anuj. And in fact, we will be keeping a cautious view on the stock because as such, we have not been taking a general positive call across the board on the sector. And we have been very selective in taking a buy call on maybe stocks like Aurobindo Pharma, Glenmark, DB's Lab, Sun Pharma, and maybe, you know, Lupin to just add into the list. And in fact, that makes quite an exhaustive list because ultimately you need to see from the regulatory clearances point of view instead of, you know, having any of such issues seen cropping up. So it is better to remain away from these stocks and only focus on the few frontliners, 4 or 5 stocks, which I've just mentioned.
Mr. Tulsian, the stock I'm going to go back to is Titan Industries. You know, I know we've discussed this in the past because a lot has happened. And if you just pull up maybe a 6 month chart of Titan today, it's up just about 0.5% or so. But something seems to be going amiss, would you say that? Because ever since we had Mr. Jhunjhunwala sell out, then there was a big rally after that. But look at the way the stock is falling consistently, down quite a bit from its peak. What's the advice here?
So, in fact, from 825, we have been taking a positive call on the stock, and thereafter, we have seen the stock moving swiftly to 900 also. And in fact, let me just add here that 3 stocks, in fact, if you are convinced on the sector growth and particularly for the stock, you know, in which they are operating, in fact, 3 stocks along with Titan, I would say Indiabulls Housing Finance and maybe Eicher Motor. Because if you really see these 3 stocks having corrected, I'm not saying that Titan have corrected in this last maybe couple of months, but Eicher has corrected in this last maybe about couple of weeks, and Indiabulls Housing has also corrected in last couple of months. So probably I think all these 3 stocks, since you have asked me on Titan, I'm just trying to add the other similar pattern, you know, where in fact one should really be, you know, picking up as an investment theme on all these stocks. I think that maybe Titan again, you know, should surprise with a positive number for Q1, because that will factor in the festive demand and the marriage season demand as well. And the price at 800 rupees seem to be quite, you know, attractive at these levels. So I won't be hesitating in initiating buy call on Titan at the current level.
Okay. Dilip, I wanted your thoughts on a couple of these aviation names, Interglobe in particular. You reckon it's a good risk reward right now, or would you want to avoid it?
Well, I think the high oil prices really has taken a toll on this particular sector. And I think even the results were not all that great in the past quarter. But I think going forward, if one were to think slightly on a longer term basis, I think the passenger load factor still continues to be very strong. And I think when there is such a good volume growth, which is happening in the sector, I don't think that it's a cause for worry that oil prices are going to go up a little more. I think, and the nature of the entire business is that it's such that it throws up a fair amount of free cash for the company and for the sector. So as such, even for the sector, I am still positive in the longer run. Some the higher oil prices can spook some of the bigger gains, but I still think that this particular sector, and particularly Indigo, can really do very well over next 12 to 18 months. I would still be very positive on this.
Some interesting moves on the mid-cap side of the market. Let's pull up Delta Corp. Stock is at the lows of the day, 5%. That's a lot of selling on Delta Corp that we're seeing today. It's anyway had a very range-bound last couple of months. Stock hasn't done much and it's falling quite a bit today. The other one worth noting perhaps is going to be Hathway. These stocks anyway have been damaged so badly after the Jio Fiber rollout announcement. Hathway is down another 4%, 5%. Look at the big fall coming in on this one. Dilip, any thoughts? Particularly, I won't ask you about the cable guys or the MSOs. I mean, we've discussed that a lot. Technology is really changing. But what about Delta Corp?
Well, we are not really covering this company at the moment, so I don't have a fair idea, except for the fact that I think this business sooner than later will witness still a stronger growth. But very frankly, I have not had a grip on this company.
Okay, Mr. Hussain, we have discussed this in the past as well, but India Cements is up 3.5% today. Most of these stocks have lost quite a bit of value over the last 3 or 4 months. Any interesting stock apart from India Cement that you would like?
See, Anuj, I think in this last couple of weeks, in fact, all the cement stocks are seen catching up. And in fact, we are keeping quite positive bias. Maybe this monsoon of couple of months, but if you really see the pricing power, which you have, in fact, the price increase, which we have seen in this last couple of weeks, which is very unusual that you see the cement companies increasing the prices in the month of June. That is obviously, maybe to complete the projects ahead of monsoon, many of the public works and all that. And post-monsoon, I think things are seen going to be quite favorable in favor of the cement companies, giving them operating leverage due to increase in the capacity utilization and the way the consolidation scene having happened. So taking this theme forward, we are keeping positive bias maybe on the stocks like Ultratech Cement, Ramco Cement and maybe Shree Cement, which has been also continuously increasing. If you really see all these prominent cement stocks, they've all risen by about 10% in this last maybe 2 to 3 weeks. So continuing with these themes, naturally India Cement is seen more as a trading stocks. The fundamentals are seen on an improvement. But if you really want to be in the safe and growth-oriented stocks, then three or four stocks like Ultratech Cement, Ramco Cement and Shree Cements really qualifies as buy.
Okay, and Mr. Hussain, before we let you go, how much more would you give this sugar rally, Balrampur Chini in particular, 8% higher?
No, Anuj, I think this should be used as an exit opportunity. I don't think that things are really seen quite, but though the prices have been hardening, but the kind of indications which we have been seeing for the next season also, though the ethanol is also giving them good this one, but I don't think that you should, there is no fresh buy call, but those who have been holding it, these all rallies should be used as an exit opportunity.
All right, Mr. Tulsian, we let you go on that note. Thanks a lot for joining us. Some news, SEBI sources, CNBC TV 18, no further extension to companies for meeting 25% public shareholding norm, given 4 years to meet, and that perhaps is it. So you'll have to bring your stake down to 75%. Would this include the
PSUs? Yes,
the government companies.
That's what Sapna sources are saying, Anuj, that PSUs won't get any further extension, any timeline. That's the indication, but yeah, I don't know.
Rules for PSUs can change.
They can change on a dime. We know that.
Special
class.
Yeah, exactly. That's a special class, of course. But anyway, that's an important bit of news. Dilip, before we thank you, I wanted your thoughts on this TCS versus Infosys gap, which is now getting bigger and bigger. Your thoughts.
Well, I think TCS is only confirming its eminent status at the moment. But as far as Infosys is concerned, I think it will do the catching up game without any doubt. because I don't think there will be so much of difference between the two. Of course, without any doubt, TCS has a very good lead over Infosys. But having said that, I would still feel that Infosys also will qualify as a good buy, say over a period of next 12 to 14 months. And even in terms of some kind of tailwinds that the currency is also going to provide to them, even in the short run, and that is also for the sector. But I think for Infosys, it would still mean that next 12 to 14 months, we should see some kind of meaningful growth in the company and accompanied by a stock price climb.
All right, Dilip, we'll let you go on that note. Thanks a lot for joining us today. But, well, the weekly Bank Nifty options expiry in about 7 minutes. We'll have the 3 p.m. move, if at all. Now, in the morning, we had P.R. Sundar joining us. He told you that the trade that he took was to sell the 26,800 and 900 put, even took a 27,000 put trade. Now, let's just quickly bring those options back on screen. 26,800 and 26,900 would be next to zero. 26,900 is 0.90, so that's almost zero. Entire premium gone there, about 99.5%. 26,800 put premium also is almost zero. Now, 27,000 put is what I'm interested in right now, because if you would have sold it, in that case, there's still a risk. The premium is down, of course, quite a bit, but still trading at about 10 rupees. Now, you don't know. The market is, interesting. Anything could happen in last hour. So, we have Sundar joining us again. Sundar, good afternoon. So, it worked out. Intraday, though, there was some bit of decline that took place. How did you manage that?
Yeah, the trade went very well, but the joke I did in the morning did not go well with some viewers, right? I did not mean to demean the ladies, you know. Believe me, I'm living with only one lady for the last 25 years. Okay, I apologize if anybody felt offended. I told you in the morning very clearly that it is risky to sell 27,000 put option. I told you wait for some kind of intraday dip to sell. Right, and that has also worked very well. And 26,900 and 26,800, as you have mentioned,
you're squared off those now?
No, normally I do not square up because
it will get auto squared off now at 5 paise or whatever.
Correct.
So, 27,000 put, you would still, there's 10 rupees there. Did you sell it and you want to?
Yeah, I sold it around 24 rupees.
You would now make that as your stop loss?
Yes. Entry will be the stop loss.
Entry will be the stop loss. So for those who are trying to understand it here, he sold it at 27, and why he would want to keep a 27 rupees stop loss is, in case the market decides all of a sudden to have a 100-200 point tumble, in that case that put premium will go up rather swiftly. So don't want to lose any money if you've already made money or making mark-to-market profit on that. But you know, you don't want to square off right now, because this 8.5 rupee also is a decent amount of money that you would want to eat right now. Any trades that you're taking for next series now?
The next series, usually I do a lot of positional trade. Okay, the intraday trade, I do it only on Thursdays. And normally I do a lot of ratio spreads. And say, for example, the Bank Nifty has been trading between 26,000 to 27,000 for the last few months. So I bought 26,000 put option. Okay.
Bought
26,000 put option.
Now, these are positional trades. This is not intraday,
this is not intraday
expiry day trade. Okay.
No, it's a positional trade. Okay. And sold 25,500, 25,000, 24,500 and 24,000 put options, double the quantity each.
Okay, that is to bring your cost down, but the risk is if the market collapses in this case.
Yeah, okay. See, if you forget about the Lehman Brothers collapse in 2008, in all other black swan events, the Bank Nifty fell the maximum 1,200 point. Okay, option sellers, they are not worried about the movement of the market, but they are worried about the gap up and gap down. So the maximum gap down happened in the last many times, it was 1,200. So we take care of that, that amount.
Okay. So, and as you were explaining in the morning, I mean, I thought you said that maybe today, because the market seems very unidirectional, that you will only look at perhaps, going with one option. I mean, only look at selling
calls, the put option.
Selling the puts.
Yeah, correct.
But usually you do both.
Yeah, usually we do
so
both.
You sell the calls and the puts.
Yes, and today also I let the market to run its course, and then I sold some call options like 27,200, 300 and 400.
200, 300, 400, okay. But that would also be close to zero now. But, okay, but Sundar, thanks a lot for joining us. So that's, of course, the weekly options expiry on Bank Nifty. We'll take a break and be back with BTST calls, hopefully before 3 p.m., if there's any 3 p.m. move on the Bank Nifty.
And we also get chatting with our alpha manager of the day, Rajesh Kothari, who runs the portfolio at Alpha Accurate Advisors, is joining in. We'll find out what they're buying and selling in the market.